so desperately hoping for another tremendous tie as we had late last night, but it doesn't look as if it's going to materialise. But the one thing I've learnt, never ever predict in sport. How many people would have thought that in the World Cup semi-final, the host Brazil would be thrashed 7-1 by Germany? This man played well last night, Ueda. So we know he's in good form, but it is a tall order. Well, there's already a roar before Lindan's name has even been called out. Just oozes star quality. Lindan of China, the 31-year-old from Longyan near Fuzhou in Fujian province. Shen of Chinese Taipei. Well, this is the third time in this Sudwin Cup campaign that Lindan has been selected. What a luxury for a team to have a choice between the two-time Olympic champion or the world champion as your number one men's singles player.
And I think you have one of the explanations there for the 3-0 score in the finals, that the other teams, they fight so hard to get to the finals, whereas China is able to rest their players.
Yes, very good point. 26-year-old Takuma Ueda, born in Tokyo, 25 in the world ranking. At the moment, his win-loss record for the year, 7 tournaments, a couple of quarterfinals, the Swiss Grand Prix Gold, India Super Series event. Now, he got his first outing yesterday evening against Sungwan Ho of Korea. He lost that match, but there was a little bit of controversy right at the end because the umpire called a fault on Ueda for hitting the net. We had the privilege of being able to watch it again, and we believe that an incorrect call was made. But, you know, that's life, that's sport, and you've got to accept the decisions at the time. So Lindan, former world number one, currently number two. Say two-time Olympic champion, five-time world champion. Two finals from four tournaments this year, winning the Asia Championships and losing in the final of Malaysia. He played against Mark Schwebler twice, once in the group and then again in the quarter final. And that quirk of the regulations that say that the winners of the four groups in the level one division will be seeds, and then everybody else is drawn, which means that you can draw the same team as you played in your group. Just one previous meeting, won by Lindan in the quarterfinal stage of that Chinese Taipei Grand Prix Gold last year. As you saw, fairly comfortable, 15-10. Well, Japan fielding a man that's only their fourth highest player on the world ranking. But the fact that Japan have got four men's singles players in the top 25 is quite remarkable. The highest ranked player, of course, Momota, who was playing earlier but suffered a knee injury and therefore couldn't play in the semi-final last night. He's at number 8. You've got Kenichi Targo at 18, who wasn't even selected for the Sudirman Cup. Sho Sasaki, the veteran, at 17, and this man at 25. Holding up proceedings. Something stuck to the bottom of the shoe. So the Olympic champion, can he deliver the final point required for China to retain the Sudirman Cup? On the right, as we look at them. Pressure on Takuma Ueda. Nobody's expecting him to win this. Everybody looked at the lineup and said, well, Lin Dan for the men's singles. And that sometimes just gives you the freedom to be able to play without pressure.
To be able to challenge Lin Dan in terms of technical skills or accuracy, but perhaps the speed can help him. Very fast player, Japanese.
Now it's landed in. Good length on the clear from Ueda. Oh.
of cheering. The Japanese girls.
Yeah, tight right too. Shot so early, simple little block. Just watch this, how his racket arm goes out. That's fabulous.
Fully balanced. That is one of the differences on the good players and the marvelous touch the defense.
Perspective. Kira Masuda, Japanese men's singles coach. Oof, good serve.
For Ueda, he made the mistake of playing Lindan with time in his forehand. That clear is so well disguised, and the clear back is not good enough, and is punished by Lindan by this beautiful cross smash. From the forehand side, there's some sort of natural deception. Perhaps practiced a lot of hours, but there, at least there's a very, very nasty deception on all Lindan's shots. Very, very hard to read, whereas the backhand side is more human. The long backhand, that is.
Tactic, that body attack from Ueda.
Yeah, when it comes to the flat game, I think it's a good idea to test Lindan in the flat game. There is some possibilities. Depends on the skills of his opponent, of course, but definitely there's some possibilities. We've also seen it in some of the earlier matches, that smash to his hips are a possibility. There it's repeated. And definitely the wise choice if you haven't got a really big opportunity. because if you're smashing to one of the sides on those occasions, you're pretty much going to lose the initiative due to this excellent touch of Ndana.
Pressure
in the forehand side, then you're going to be in trouble. Maybe you could much rather play the short forehand. That's not as dangerous, not as easy to disguise. That's, for instance, the short backhand.
But there was nothing special about it, wasn't it?
Nothing at all. He simply has to cover that weeder, otherwise he's not compatible in this match. Pressure on him in his long backhand side. It's not that he's not dangerous, he's just not as dangerous as in his forehand.
Do you remember when we were in the early stages of this sort of cup competition, you and I were sitting watching Lee Chong Wei, and it was quite close to the mid-game, mid-game interval, and then suddenly he'd pull away, and I'm just sort of thinking, I'm just waiting for that to happen with Lin Dan here.
Yep, I agree, because we haven't seen a really fast-paced game.
Yeah, there's Sha Shanzhe, quick to talk to his man.
Tell him to work the long backhand corner combined with the short forehand corner of Lin Dan. Be patient, get the defense in place in terms of defending Lin Dan from the long backhand corner, and then just be patient, wait for the opportunity, hit some few steep smashes to the side and heavy smashes to the body.
Well, service fault called.
And Lin Dan doesn't really know what that is. He's not experienced that before. What is going on?
Yeah, racket not pointing in a downward direction. Said our service judge. Let's have another look at that.
That's ridiculous.
Bart from Australia, our service judge.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
Well played. It's also very important to sort of take your chances at the net and try to play really, really sharp when you get the opportunity.
This is where I sense Linda may make a little bit of a move.
Yeah, you're always expecting to go sort of 3 points clear or something like that.
Yeah. Oh, that's extraordinary. He played that without a proper backswing.
Yeah.
Straight arm.
Notice the legs of Takuma Ueda whenever he plays Lindan in this forehand corner. He's never able to move early. Always reacting to the shot coming from Lindan.
Where his feet are inside that double service line. Well, when you know you can hit winners even off a good length, clear.
And for coaches it should be fairly easy to do winner analysis, see how many winners Lindan hits from his forehand side and how many winners he hits from his backhand side, and that should more or less direct the strategy that the players apply when playing against this fantastic player.
Oh, what can you do against sheer brilliance like that? How on earth did he play that? Get out of trouble. Well, it was 11:13 when I said I was expecting him to make a move. And he has obliged. 5 straight points. Well, that's an indication of his confidence.
Simply not able to read which shot is coming to Takuma Ueda. This is okay, there was pressure on the shot to the forehand side. This is not okay.
last 9 points, when we said he was going to make a move, we weren't kidding, were we? Of the last 10 points now. Well, it really is a trait of champions, isn't it? The ability to win points at will. Just pile on the pressure whenever they choose. Six game point opportunities. Wide opening game to Lin Dan of China. 21-15. Well, we said he has this ability just to suddenly increase the intensity. But here is where he's directing his smashes. Lin Dan. Isn't that great variation? You would expect perhaps more down the forehand side, would you think?
But here is statistics that to show everything, because this shows smashes from both sides and from the backhand sides. It's far more common that Lin Dan smashes straight, and therefore the 53%. Whereas the variation comes from the forehand side, and had we had that only from the forehand side, I would suspect it would be much more even.
Yeah. Testing the new racket.
Second game,
level three. So China just one game away from winning a sixth consecutive Sudan Cup, a tenth in total. Thank you. That's a nice drop. Yes. Yeah, it's landed in. That's a lovely play from Takuma Ueda.
Particularly like the reverse drop.
Yeah,
sliced reverse drop straight. We've seen in earlier tournaments this year that it has the potential to take just a half a step of indent.
Gasp from the crowd as Lindan looked as if he was going to leave one at the back of the court and then decided to play it. But look at this.
And you simply have to play that sharp in your own backhand side, because you won't get a lot of opportunities of putting pressure on Lindan, so you need to take these chances. Serving to the sideline because Lindan is standing really close to the middle.
Oh, Lindan decides that the shuttle wasn't good enough, even though his opponent was happy to serve with it. Turn error.
To the forehand side of Takuma Ueda, making it difficult for the Japanese to put pressure on Lindan's backhand side. So we need to control the side drift.
Five. Oh, that's good defence. My goodness.
Fantastic defence.
Full stretch. How did he generate the pace to flick that to the back? Could well be the longest rally of the match so far. Yeah, indeed it is. Of shot, is it?
Yeah.
It's the movement here.
Yeah.
Look at this. Look at it.
And it's also the fact that the players know that there's a possibility that he can actually smash it totally cross. And there's not so many players that use that from the forehand side, so. As well. He's watching this match, I think. The president of the PWF, Warren Collier.
Well, that just proving your point because, you know, how do you tell?
You can't.
No.
You can't tell. And that's the problem.
Yeah, so this one, cross court.
Yeah. And he's nowhere near it.
Well, it's getting faster. Apologises for hitting his opponents.
Yeah, last chance for coaching, I think, for Keita Masuda and Park Jubong. Not an easy task for the Koreans.
Well, Japan can be proud of this man's effort and performance. He really has fought hard, hasn't he?
Yeah, he was sort of thrown into the game last night. Played well, had an unfortunate end to that match, and was selected for doping control afterwards. Just played against a better player.
Can't do anything about that. Linda not happy with the mopping up that's been done.
Angry look at the mopper.
Sensing the right time for another little push from Lin Dan.
Yeah, I think time is running out for Japan. I don't think there's any need for Takahashi and Matsutomo to start warming up.
Back the Japanese side.
got five individual world championships, Lindan. What if we count the teams as well? It's going to be a lot.
Have a challenge. Yes, good man.
A little bit late, perhaps, that challenge.
Yeah.
But anyway, exciting for us to see if the linesman was right.
Yeah, I thought it was mighty close. That's why I was urging him to have a challenge. I thought it may have clipped the line.
Yeah, I saw him look back.
Yeah, indeed it did. Great challenge.
See the flags are being marched in, being made ready for the victory ceremony. That's quite odd that the players actually can see that.
Good defense.
Punched the cameraman in the face at the same time. Very good knockout. Great pictures.
Yeah, no question, it was wrong. Straight points. Wide. Three points needed.
Yeah, and as expected, Lindan has been in control throughout the match.
points required. Sudderman cut points for China. Delaying the inevitable, one suspects. Look at that. Oh, clever. China retain the Sudderman Cup for a 10th time. They will lift the prestigious trophy and can claim the status of World Mixed Team Champions. A 6th consecutive title. How fitting that it is the two-time Olympic champion, Lin Dan, who wins the third match. 21-15, 21-13. Teammates, coaches, support staff. Well, it is a trophy that they have made their own. This was their 11th final. 11th consecutive final and a 10th Sudderman Cup title. And this is how it was won. 21-15, 21-13. In 49 minutes, and as with the previous five titles that they have won, China have won by a 3-love margin. There is confirmation. China champions once more. 3-love against Japan. We had a super men's doubles to start it off. And Li Shuerui, well, she was pushed all the way in the women's singles against Akane Yamaguchi. In fact, had to save a game point against the 17-year-old Japanese player, but you can rely on Lin Dan. Lin Dan is the back big match player. Come the big tournament, come the important matches, and Lin Dan so often delivers, and he's delivered once again today. But a great all-round performance, Steen, by China.
Yeah, very strong performance throughout the tournament. Was never really under pressure. Indonesia challenged in the semi-final, but was the ladies' doubles was sort of saw the Indonesian challenge off after a good first game by Reisha and Maheswari. And today, the men's doubles initiated Chinese victory.
Well, she looked nervous at times, did you fire away?
He didn't.
He didn't. He was oozing confidence with every shuttle he struck.
An exhibition match we got from Lin Dan.
Yeah, great variety of shot, great confidence. We even tried a couple of trickery shots behind the back and a couple of dives, which of course are very spectacular for us to watch. Of course, the prize presentation will come up shortly, and of course, the Sudirman Cup itself, the trophy presented to the International Federation by Dick Sudirman, who was a former Indonesian badminton player. He was also founder of the Badminton Association of Indonesia and was chairman of that national association for 22 years. Also became the vice president of the IBF, as it was back then in 1975, and Dick Sudirman presenting this trophy because he felt that the sport of badminton should have a mixed team competition, and look where that has taken us. Our sports can boast equality in that we play all five disciplines in all our major tournaments. The trophy itself is